Hello friends, myself Selena Fernandez, assistant professor at Indira Institute of Pharmacy, Sadavli. In today's lecture, we are going to see different heterocyclic compound and chemistry of those heterocyclic compound. So, heterocyclic compounds or ring structure is a cyclic compound that has atoms of at least two different element as member of its ring. So, in ring structure of heterocyclic compound, two different elements are present. So, heterocyclic compounds also called as an heterocycles. Any of a major class of an organic chemical compound characterized by the fact that some or all of the atoms in their molecule are joined in ring containing at least one atom of an element other than carbon. So, we have to know that whenever you have an heterocyclic structure, the ring contains two different atoms. One is carbon and another element is other than carbon atom. So heterocyclic chemistry is a branch of an organic chemistry dealing with the synthesis, properties and applications of these heterocycles. Compound classified as heterocyclic probably constitute the largest and most varied family of organic compounds. So, heterocyclic compounds are organic compounds that contain a ring structure containing atom in addition to carbon, such as sulfur, oxygen or nitrogen as the heteroatom. So, three important heteroatoms which are present in heterocyclic compounds are sulfur, oxygen and nitrogen. So, these heterocyclic compounds may be aromatic or may be non-aromatic. Whenever you have a cyclic compound, you have to find out that whether it is homocyclic compound or whether it is heterocyclic compound. If compound contains ring made up of only carbon atom, then you can say that it is homocyclic compound. The two examples of homocyclic compound we can say cyclopentadiene and benzene, in which rings is made up of only carbon atoms. There are number of homocyclic compounds are present in the chemistry. Then second one is an heterocyclic compounds. So compound contains ring made up of carbon atoms and another kind of atoms like nitrogen, oxygen and sulfur are known as an heterocyclic compounds. There are of two types, that is aromatic heterocycles and non-aromatic heterocycles. In aromatic heterocycle, the examples are pyrrole, furan and thiophene. And in non-aromatic heterocycle, you can see the examples like pyrrolidine, then tetrahydrofuran. To be classified as an aromatic compound, the compound must possess the following parameters. The main important parameter that cyclic compound must be coplanar. The structure must be cyclic. Then each atom of the ring must have p orbital. So p orbital is a very important orbital which is present in heterocyclic compound to form the delocalized pi system. That is, sp2 hybridized, no atom in the ring can be sp3 hybridized. So each and every atom must be sp2 hybridized. Then another important parameter is that in cyclic compound, the ring system must be conjugated. So conjugation must be present, that is presence of C double bond C single bond C double bond C structure. Then the important parameter is that it follows the Huckel rule. Each and every heterocyclic compound follows the Huckel rule. So whenever you have a problem related to the aromaticity, you can find out whether it follows the Huckel rule or not. If it follows the Huckel rule, then the compound is aromatic. And if it does not follow the Huckel rule, then it is a non-aromatic compound. The formula for Huckel rule is 4n plus 2 pi. 4n plus 2 is equal to pi electron. Okay. So, by solving this equation, whenever you will get n is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, like integral numbers, you can say that this cyclic compound is an heterocyclic compound. And a if the number of N is not integral, then you can say that it is a non-aromatic compound. So this technique or this formula was first developed by Erik Haeckel. Then heterocyclic compounds contains elements that are found most commonly together with carbon in a ring system are nitrogen, oxygen or sulfur with the replacement of one carbon atom. So if we are going to see this reaction, in this structure, one carbon atom is replaced with heteroatom. Most specifically, these heteroatoms are nitrogen, oxygen or sulfur. So now we'll see this classification of heterocyclic compound. So classification according to the number of ring component. If the ring component, whenever going to see the ring component, and if the ring only is one, then this type of classification is called as a monocyclic heterocycles, in which one ring is present. Okay, so three member heterocycle, the examples are ethylene oxide oxirenes. Another example is ethylene imine. So it's also known as an aziridine. So these are three member heterocycles. Similarly, four member heterocycles are present, then five member heterocycles and six member heterocycle, in which one heteroatom is present. So this is a classification based on the number of ring components. So this is a six member heterocycles. Then another classification is based on two rings fused with each other. So these are the bicyclic compounds. Examples are quinoline and indole. Then C, third one is polycyclic compounds, in which more than two rings are attached with each other and at least one ring contains an heteroatom. So the examples of this type of compounds are carbazole and acridine. Then different category of classification is according to the number of heteroatoms present in the ring. If we are going to consider six member ring based on the number of heteroatom, if only one nitrogen is present, then it is pyridine. If two nitrogens are present at one and third position in six member ring, then it is known as an pyrimidine. And if three nitrogens are present, then it is known as 1,3,5 triazine. Similarly, for oxygen, the numbering is based on the presence of oxygen atom. So first one is 1,2-dioxane, then 1,3-dioxane and 1,4-dioxane. Then third one is classification according to the position of heteroatoms to each other. So in that, the examples are 1,3-oxazole, 1,2-oxazole, 1,3-diazole and 1,2-diazole. Like that, number of atoms are present. Thank you. The remaining part we'll see in next lecture. Specifically, we'll see the nomenclature of heterocyclic compound.